Hello friends, welcome to today's video. And today in this video we'll be discussing the chapter 3 of the book Aviation and Business Management. So we'll be discussing all about the finance, how the finance works in the management and how the finance important roles and responsibilities are there in the organization. You know, the definition of finance, it can be defined as it is art as well as a science, both of management of money, including the activities of investing, borrowing, lending, budgeting, saving and forecasting. So all these are some of the important areas where the finance has to focus, that is investing the money, where you have to invest, and if at all there is a shortage of money, from where you have to borrow, then lending the money to some of the people who need so that you gain some interest out of that money. Then budgeting, you have to make appropriate budgets for the financial years as to how you will be spending that and how much money you need to save, and you have to forecast the amount of money that is needed based on the future also. So all these things you have to manage, all the money that is involving all these things you have to take care. So it is an art as well as a science. Science is because it involves the mathematics and statistics and all these things, whereas it is an art because it is being carried by humans, and there is no straightforward answer to how to invest the money, how to save the money. It is an art, just like the management. So this is a broad definition of management. So if we have to explain finance in short, it is mainly concerned with the effective fund management in the business or the organization. Next, so since finance deals with all the things of forecasting, saving, current situation and all these things, so there is a need to have a financial plan as to how you will be spending the money or the funds that are there with the organization. So the financial planning is calculating the amount of capital that is required by an organization and then determining its allocation. So first, how much you need to know, how much money you need to have or how much funds you need to have with the organization, and then you have to decide on the allocation of it as to how you will be using it. So this process of knowing how much money that is needed and then using it appropriately, that is allocating it, is the financial process, means financial planning process. Next is, whenever you are, now you had know that you need to have a financial plan, so what are the components or the objectives of the financial plan are? First is, of course, you need to know how much capital is required. I'll be discussing the capital in detail in the future part of this video. Okay, there are many types of capital. So amount of capital that is required, determine the capital organization and the structure. Capital is of different forms: assets, money, infrastructure, and so many things. So how you will organizational structure of the, not organizational structure, the capital organization structure you need to have. Next is how you will need to frame some of the financial policies and regulations. You know, how the money will be spent, you need to have some policies. Policies are nothing but the guidelines. So these guidelines or these policies will help you in the allocation and spending of that fund. Next is, you need to have a control of how these activities will be carried out in a financial management. So whenever you create a financial plan, then you need to have all these, you need to keep all these things in mind, starting with the amount of capital required, ending with the financial control. So these you have to remember. Next is the importance. Since we have known from the definition that funds are important with the organization, so the financial management importance are, it helps the organization in financial planning, it assists in planning and acquisition of fund. Once you have a financial plan, then you will know that how much fund is actually needed. So if you don't have that fund, then you need to acquire some funds, acquisition, then you have to carry with the acquisition of funds, like taking loan from the bank or taking loan from the market. So these are some of the things in which financial management helps you. It helps the organization effectively utilizing and allocating the funds, assist organization in making critical financial decisions. helps in improving the profitability, since you know how much funds are there and how much assets are there, and then based on your financial plan, if you use it judiciously, cautiously, it may lead to the profitability of the organization. It increases overall value and also provides economic stability to the organization. These are some of the importance of the financial management. Next is, since we have just said finance can also lead to economic stability, and you know, finance, there are many objectives, but then broadly if you talk, finance will only deal with these two. Either they will concentrate about the profit maximization, that is earning more profits or earning more money or earning more capital. That is one of the objective. Or the second is wealth maximization. Wealth is assets and cash in hand, and so many things are there. So broadly it can be categorized into profit and wealth maximization. You just need to remember them. If at all they comes into exam, it will help you that these are some of the parts of the financial objectives. So let's say if you are a manager in a company and you are dealing with the finance, then what are the roles and responsibilities of the financial manager? First is, they have to have a financial plan, that is preparing the financial plan, then project revenues, expenditure, financial needs over the given period. This you have to carry out this task, then investing the money, how you will be spending the money. So this you have to take care, and then also how you have to have a plan of how to raise the money. So if you're a financial manager, you are having all these roles and responsibilities with you. So how you will raise the money, and also you have to maintain the best balance between the debt. Debt is the borrowed funds. These are the key terms: debts, borrowed funds, equity, fund raised to the sale of ownership of the business. Just remember the definitions. If they ask in the exam, you can answer them. We need not go much into the details. You know, as we have just said, financial management is all about handling the capital. So what is actually capital? Capital is basically refers to the total investment of the company in terms of money and assets. So how much money the company has invested, and what are its assets? So these is nothing but the capital. Next is, it is a total wealth of the company. This is the definition of capital. Total wealth of the company is a capital. So wealth can be of many types, you know, assets, infrastructures, money in hand, money in terms of sales, bonds, mutual funds, and many other things. So when a company is going to invest large amount of finance into the business, it is called as capital. This is other definition. So in short, you can remember the total wealth of the company, including the money and assets, mutual funds, and all those things. Next, what are the type of capital? One is the fixed capital, another is the working capital. Fixed capital is needed for meeting the permanent or long-term purposes of the business concern. Like let's say you are purchasing a computer. So that will be your capital asset. So it will be used for the long term, you know, the computer will be used. So it's a long term purchase, or it will be useful for the long term. Since when you're spending such type of money for purchase of such type of things, then that can be broadly classified as a fixed capital, which are permanent or long term purposes of the business. The computer will easily run for 5 to 8 years. So it's a long term investment. So these type of things are fixed capital. Like fixed capital is used to acquire the fixed assets of the business concern. Fixed asset is just as like computers, land, property, software, purchase, all these things. So these are non-recurring. Like once you have purchased, they will be there with you. You need not purchase them again. Let's say you have acquired the property, let's say 100 acres of land. So it's a one-time investment. Once you have purchased, then you have purchased. You will not purchase again and again. So these are non-recurring in nature. So that is a fixed capital. Next is our working capital. Working capital is needed to meet the day-to-day transaction of the business concern. You know, like the salaries, bills, and all. These are the working capital. Like normally working capital consists of various components of current assets like inventories, bills, cash, bank balance, prepaid expenses, purchase of raw materials, wages to the laborers, salaries, which are every electricity bill, telephone bill, all these things which are everyday or happening on a monthly basis, which are recurring in nature. These you cannot avoid. You need to spend the money and are recurring. So these are working capital. This you need to remember, the fixed capital and the working capital. These knowing the having the knowledge of these is a must for managers, you know, because only then they will be able to allocate the fund. Even though you are handling airport operations, let's say you have got the job, then you will be having the working capital with you as well as the financial capital. You need to make a planning of these two things. Even though you are not from finance, but then you need to have the financial knowledge of these things. So that is why these are important for anybody who is working in the management. So now we'll move to some of the general knowledge related to finance in India. You know how financial system works in India. Financial system provides adequate and smooth flow of finance to the needed parts. In short, how the money or how the assets, or in short how the finance is flowing into the system of economy is what it provides. So it is concerned about the money, loan and the finance. So Indian financial system, you know, there are four components. Those are financial institution, financial markets, financial instruments and financial services. Financial institutions are banking and non-banking. Mainly you can remember bankings, banks and non-banks. So these are the financial institutions. If at all you need some money, then from these institutions you can always collect the money. So banks are a part of the financial institutions of financial system of India. Next is financial markets. Financial markets provides money and capital supply to the industrial concern as well as promote the savings. So there are capital markets and money markets. You know, these can be known as a non-banking. So they provide the money and capital supply. So these you just remember the term. You need not go much into this. This is a very huge chapter. We are just cutting it short. So just remember the financial institutions are banking and non-banking. Then one of the component of the financial system is the financial markets. Next is financial instruments. So financial instrument is like you can say money, you know, cash, 100 rupees, 200 rupees. So using these only you're carrying out the transactions. So these are some of the instruments which are helping you to run the finance. So these provide efficient flow of transfer of capital throughout the world, act as a channel to invest the money. It is a tool to can be categorized into cash instruments and derivative instruments. So like simple cash, 100 rupees notes, 200 rupees notes, because only with that you are able to carry out the transactions, financial transaction. So these are the instruments. So just remember that derivative instruments can be in the form of electoral bonds or having some other mutual funds and all, which are having some financial value, but then they are non-cash. You can just remember them as cash instruments and non-cash instruments. I think this would be sufficient. Next is financial services. So normally financial services are provided non-banking financial companies. So these are two types, fund-based and fee-based. You need not go much into detail. You just remember some of the key financial institutions in India are SEBI, SEBI, which is the Securities and Exchange Board in India. So all the things related in India with means the responsibility of dealing with the matters of the capital market are with the SEBI. This is a key organization. You can learn more by Googling it. I'm just giving you a hint and the full form. Next is IPO is one more important key term. You know, IPO is whenever a company issues share to a public for the first time use. So now, you know, many of the companies like LIC and other, which are PSUs, initially they were having all the shares with them. So now they are available for public to purchase. So common man can purchase some of the shares of that. So whenever a company is selling its shares to the common public, then it is known as the IPO. this you have to remember, this is a part of a general knowledge, and of course we need to have this knowledge also for our daily use. This is IPO. So in IPO, now this company is issuing the share, so who will handle the shares in India? So in India, mostly share trading actively happens in stock exchanges. So the process of buying and selling the shares is a term share trading, and it actively happens in stock exchanges. So what are the important stock exchanges in India? There are primarily two. One is the Bombay Stock Exchange and the National Stock Exchange, with the BSE and NSE. This you can remember, you might have heard in the news, they'll say stock market has gone high, stock market has gone low. So what they are saying is these exchange they are referring to the stock exchange that are happening. So this is all about the finance. In short, if you have to remember finance, how you will manage the funds, how you will allocate the funds, how you will control the fund. Fund can be of cash in hand or in terms of assets, how you will maintain the policies. So all these things are about the finance. So these are some of the key terminologies in finance. Just remember the definition, read through the chapter. If at all something comes in the exam, you will be in a better position to answer them. So if you have liked this short video on finance, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos. And thank you for watching.